Greetings and welcome to the Militant Negro YouTube channel. I made a very big boo-boo a few minutes ago. I received some information about a brand new alternative to Twitter, a social media platform using a Twitter-like template called Gab. Come to find out, Gab is the alt-right social media alternative to people who were banned by Twitter and Facebook for using racist hate speech, or just plain old hate speech, period. Seems these people got kicked off of Twitter and Facebook, excuse me, a few months ago, and decided they needed a place they could congregate and meet up to continue their racist hate speech, hate mongering, fear mongering, whatever you want to call it, where they wouldn't be censored for being hateful, evil, racist ass wipes. That place was created by a cat named Andrew Torba, who is the CEO of Gab.ai, a new quote unquote freedom of speech focused social network. It's a Twitter style network that was launched last Monday. It's in the early beta stages of testing, but there have been hundreds of thousands of people currently on a wait list, of which I was one until a few minutes ago. And these people are waiting for an invitation to join Gab as accounts, users, clients. This is amazing to me because I must have had my head buried in the sand and did not know that Gab even existed until I received an invitation to join the wait list via email. I have no clue how Gab got my email address. Luckily, it's one of several I have and one that I consider a throwaway email address. So they don't really have access to my personal email. They have access to my anonymous email that I created so that my real email would be shielded and cloaked from this type of spam garbage. But when I got the email, I was intrigued because, yes, Twitter does censor people who do not agree with their Israeli-led beliefs. I am pro-Palestine and anti-Israel, anti-Zionist, and a lot of times, being a member of Anonymous, Twitter fucks with my account on a daily basis. So I thought Gab would be a great alternative. Come to find out, they're a racist, hate-mongering social media platform. Just want to give you a heads up about that. And here's a little bit of information about Gab from Breitbart, which is, of course, a racist blog platform. Breitbart says, and I'm quoting, "Free speech social network Gab growing as Twitter and Facebook censors their users." In just 2 weeks since its beta launch, free speech Twitter alternative Gab has already accumulated a waiting list of over 30,000 people looking to get into the platform. That's a bit outdated, because when I signed up a little bit ago, they told me 1.3 million people were in waiting line ahead of me. So this is a bit outdated for those figures. "The response to Gab from around the world has been nothing short of incredible," says Gab CEO Andrew Torba, who was talking to Breitbart at that time. This just goes to show you there are quite a few racists in the world, or people like me who unknowingly joined this waiting list. I was told by a person on Twitter who follows me and I follow him that this was an alt-right organization, a place for alt-right people, ultra-conservative right-wing nuts to meet up and spew their garbage without any interference or monitoring. At first, I didn't believe this person, but I came to find out very shortly after he was correct. So I unjoined, took my name off the waiting list, and thought it vitally important that people who might be like me were shown the true side of Gab. I'm going to continue to read. This is a movement and something that the community is driving forward, he explained, Mr. CEO Andrew Torba. Folks are deleting their Twitter and Facebook accounts or pledging to do so right after the election. Actually, folks who had Twitter and Facebook accounts who were using them for furthering and advancing hate speech and racism, they weren't deleting their accounts. Their accounts were deleted for them. They were kicked off Twitter and Facebook for forging ahead with hate speech and racist propaganda. That's the truth. Not this crap about they deleted their own accounts. That didn't happen. It goes on to say, this article, if I had to pick a single event that pushed me over the edge to take action, I would have to say it was the suppression of conservative sources and stories by the incredibly biased Facebook Trending Topics team, says CEO Andrew Torba. He continues, many of us don't realize just how much power and influence the news feed and trending topics have on our psychological understanding of the world around us. There are hundreds of millions of people who get their main source of news and information from a handful of companies in one of the most progressively liberal cities in the world. It's time for a change. At Gab, we welcome anyone who wants to speak freely. As long, probably, my own two cents here, as long as you're speaking to their agenda. See, this is what's wrong with social media, period. The people who own social media platforms, such as Facebook, Twitter, whatever other social media platform is out there, the people who own these, except for the picture social media sites like Snapchat and Instagram, the people who own social media platforms are all biased towards whatever ideology they believe in. You don't really have a social media platform that is unbiased and balanced and doesn't use censorship. I mean, the only things that need to be censored are hate speech, racial bullshit, and misinformation. You don't need to censor somebody's pure thoughts and ideas and opinions unless they border on harassment towards somebody else. Twitter censors accounts. Facebook censors accounts. I know this because my account has been censored by both of those social media platforms. And to be honest, I'm not for or against people saying what they need to say. I'm pro-Palestine, anti-Israel. That gets me banned often on Twitter. I'm on a Twitter censorship list right now. Facebook is known to support Israel and not support Palestine. And they gear all their efforts toward blocking and censoring sensitive people who are pro-Palestine, who are sympathetic to what Palestine is going through at the hands of Israel. So Gab is bad for people like me who are for things that are humane and for humanity. But Twitter and Facebook are not far behind, because I have been handled for being what I am and believing in who I am and standing for the issues that I feel responsible for as a human. So to be clear, Gab.ai, this new social media platform, is for racists. I just felt I needed to inform everybody because I was under the impression it was a breath of fresh air. And it is, just not for liberals, progressives, independents, sane, intelligent people. Just want to keep you informed. Don't make the mistake I did. I'm out of here. Namaste. Peace out.
Talking about the ghetto. Funky, funky ghetto. Trying to survive. Trying to stay alive.